हाँ गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू ज्ञान भारती जूनियर कॉलेज ऑफ साइंस कुलगांव। डियर स्टूडेंट, यस्टरडे वी हैव सीन हियर द इक्वेशन ऑफ द प्रोग्रेसिव वेव। आफ्टर दैट वी हैव सीन हियर द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द ट्रांसवर्स वेव एंड स्पीड ऑफ द ट्रांसवर्स वेव इन अ मीडियम। आफ्टर दैट वी हैव सीन द स्पीड ऑफ द लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल वेव according to the Newton's law। We calculate there the velocity of the sound in air is 279.9 meter per second। So this is the calculation means speed of the sound wave, of course that is the longitudinal wave in the air medium। So according to the Newton's formula, the speed of sound is given by speed of sound in air is v is equal to under root of what? Vector e upon rho। So this formula we have seen yesterday here, e is the elasticity of the medium, rho is the density of the medium, and in that equation the Newton's considered that the formation or the generation or the production of the compression and the rarer fraction in the longitudinal wave is considered as the isothermal process, because here during the compression the heat is generated and during the rarer fraction it is given out, that is the loss of heat। And he considered that this process means temperature remains constant according to the Newton's formula here, therefore this process is considered as the isothermal process। But here in the Laplace correction it is assumed that during the generation of the compression the heat is produced and during the rarefaction heat is given out, it is lost। So this process is the rapid process according to the one Laplace, but according to the Newton means generation of the or production of the compression and the rarefaction is the slow process according to the Newton, but according to the Laplace this process is the rapid process, this process is the fast process, there is no time for the dissipation of the heat energy। So this is the fast process, this is the rapid process according to the Laplace। So here he assumed that this process is not the isothermal process, this process is the adiabatic process, and therefore the elasticity corresponding to the adiabatic process is called as the adiabatic elasticity। Therefore according to the Laplace here the correction is made while writing here the E is the modulus of the elasticity, but here E is equal to according to the Newton it becomes R is equal to P upon rho according to the Newton, but here correction is made here E is equal to gamma P। So this is the adiabatic elasticity, E is equal to gamma P, and here gamma is the ratio of Cp upon Cv, So after putting here the value, here V is equal to 1 under root of gamma P upon rho, gamma P upon rho। So putting here the value, that is under root of 1.41 into P is equal to H, it is become 0.76 meter of Hg, Hd means 130600 means it is the density of the mercury, and Dg that is the 9.8, and after that here is the one density of the air, that is 1.3. So this calculation, while making this calculation the answer is 332.3 meter per second, meter per second। So this is the best estimate value, varying value means 332 meter per second, this is the best value of the velocity of sound in air, means here by calculation of the Laplace correction, the velocity of sound is found to be v is equal to 332.3 meter per second. This is the best value agree with the standard value of velocity of sound here. So here the Laplace made here the correction means here is equal to p is given by the Newton, but here d is equal to gamma p. This is the correction made by the Laplace. Means that gamma is the adiabatic ratio. E is the here elasticity, but just you see adiabatic elasticity. Therefore, here d is equal to gamma p. Taking here d is equal to gamma p upon rho. Means here by calculation we get here the value of 332.3 meter per second. This is the best value of the velocity of sound here. So this is called as the Laplace correction. So while calculating the value of the velocity of the sound in the air by the Newtons, the value where kitna tha 279.9 meter per second, nearly about the approximately equal to the nearly equal to the 280. So there is a difference between these two values. So here the Laplace correction gives the correct value of the velocity of sound is here, that is 332.3 meter per second. We can call this value as the 332 meter per second. So this is about the Laplace correction. So next here, effect of the pressure on velocity of sound. Effect of pressure on velocity of sound. So here we have the Laplace correction. So here according to Laplace correction we have the equation for the velocity of sound. Effect of second topic is effect of pressure on velocity of sound. Velocity of sound. So we have here the according to Laplace correction. What formula we have? Laplace correction. Kya formula hai? Velocity of sound is given by the under root of gamma p upon rho. Gamma p. So this is the formula given by the Laplace. Velocity of sound in air medium is given by the v is equal to under root of gamma p upon rho. We know here gamma is the adiabatic ratio having the value 1.41. But here if rho is the density, rho is the density, therefore here it will be the mass upon volume. Mass upon volume. Rho is the density, that is equal to the mass upon volume. M is the mass, V is the volume. Mass upon volume. Mass upon volume. So here, this equation number 1 becomes here. What? Equation number 1 becomes here. That is V is equal to, V is the velocity here. V is the volume here. So here, this will be becomes as gamma P upon m upon v, mass upon volume. So this will be written here, that is under root of gamma pv, gamma pv upon m, capital M. But here v is equal to under root of gamma pv upon m. But here for the ideal gas equation according to Boyle's law. What here? According to the Boyle's law. What is the statement? At the constant temperature, PV is equal to, that is MRT. PV is equal to MRT. So according to Boyle's law, at the constant temperature, PV is equal to MRT. PV is equal to MRT. So here, equation number 2 becomes as here. So putting in equation number 2, this equation number 2 becomes as V is equal to under root of what value? Gamma NRT upon M.
So from this equation number 3, we conclude that the direct effect of the pressure on the velocity of sound, there is no change. Means where you are going to change the pressure of the medium, then there is no effect on the velocity of sound. Yes, you are going to decrease or increase the pressure of the gas or the air or the medium, there is no change in the velocity of sound, because this equation number 3 doesn't contain here the term of the pressure. But here the pressure is connected, related to the what value? P is equal to nRT over the volume. Means जब तक कि आप टेम्परेचर में चेंज नहीं करते तब तक के ये प्रेशर में चेंज नहीं होगा. जैसे ही आप टेम्परेचर में चेंज होगा तो फिर क्या होगा, प्रेशर में चेंज होगा और अल्टीमेटली वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड पर क्या होगा, इसका इफेक्ट होगा. मीन्स जब तक के आप टेम्परेचर चेंज नहीं करते तब तक क्या प्रेशर चेंज नहीं होगा, और प्रेशर चेंज होगा तब क्या होगा, वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड होगा. जब डायरेक्टली आप प्रेशर चेंज करते हो इसका मतलब क्या होगा, देयर इज नो चेंज ऑन द वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड अंटिल द टेम्परेचर इज चेंज, अदरवाइज देयर इज नो चेंज ऑन द वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड ऑफ द प्रेशर. Means according to this equation number 3, V is equal to under root of gamma nRT. Means here nRT equal to PV. Means here there is no pressure in this equation number 3. Therefore here direct change in pressure has no effect on the velocity of sound until the change is made in the temperature. जब तक के आप temperature में change नहीं करोगे तब तक के इसमें क्या होगा, velocity of sound में change नहीं होगा. वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड डायरेक्टली प्रेशर पे डिपेंड नहीं है, इसका इसके ऊपर कुछ भी इफेक्ट गिरने वाला नहीं है. सो दिस इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रेशर ऑन वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड. दिस इक्वेशन नंबर 3 प्रूव्स हियर दैट इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ गामा nRT. मींस हियर द वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑन द प्रेशर. जब तक कि आप टेम्परेचर में चेंज नहीं करते तब तक के कोई चेंज नहीं होगा. सो दिस इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रेशर ऑन वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड. सो नेक्स्ट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर ऑन वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड. इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर देखते हैं. नाउ कंसीडर हियर इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर ऑन वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू हियर अगेन लाप्लास इक्वेशन वही हम हियर दें. सपोज वी इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड, वी इज वेलोसिटी ऑफ साउंड एट टी जीरो टेम्परेचर टी जीरो डिग्री सेल्सियस एट द केल्विन टेम्परेचर equation number 2. So dividing equation 1 by 2, we get here. What value? Dividing equation. Equation 1 by equation 2. Therefore, V upon V0 is equal to. क्या मिलेगा मुझे? A term divided by A term. क्या मिलेगा मुझे? देखो. Is under root of nRT gamma upon n. ठीक है, ये ऊपर जाएगा means gamma nRT zero upon क्या होगा means ये गैटा m zero T upon T0 means ये कैसे हो जाएगा जना T ये यहाँ पे T ये जामा होगा means यहाँ पे मिलेगा मुझे ये means ये मिलेगा मुझे T upon T0 T upon T0 ये पुटी करके ये क्वेश्चन हुआ ये ना RT but लेकिन ये क्या होगा means ये हम upon ये में देखा पड़ जाते so T upon V0 equal to nRT m r t 0 upon m m get cancel gamma gamma get cancel n n get cancel r is the constant therefore t upon t 0 means here the velocity of sound depends upon hot factor absolute temperature v upon v 0 is equal to under root of t upon t 0 it means that here the velocity of sound depends on the absolute temperature suppose here let t 0 is equal to 273 kV. Therefore, T is equal to 273 plus small t. Okay? So, putting here, it will become here, that is, V upon V0, V upon V0 is equal to under root of T ka value kitna hai? 273 plus t upon 273 means solving this you will get here 1 plus t upon 273 it means that under root of that is 1 plus a 1 upon 273 is equal to alpha is a constant alpha 1 upon 273 1 upon 273 is equal to alpha is the constant therefore this will become as alpha t so this term can be written as that is 1 plus alpha t 1 plus alpha t the power half means v upon v0 is equal to V upon V0 is equal to 1 plus alpha t to the power half. So, rearranging this term, we will get new term. Therefore, V is equal to V0 into 1 plus alpha t to the power half. Alpha is very, very small. Therefore, this term will be that is V0 1 plus that is half of the alpha into t. But here V0 into 1 plus half of the alpha means 273 into t. 273. 2 upon 273 means V0 into 1 plus. It is not that high. 2 3 is 6. 2 7 is 14. Carry 1 to the 4, 5 or 8 means ये कितना आया है means V0 1 plus 1 upon 546 और ये calculation करने के बाद आता है 1 plus 0.61 t means ये पूरा calculation करके आता है ये 1 plus A. Means, therefore here, V is equal to V0 plus, that is, V0, V0 is equal to 373. Therefore, यहाँ पे कर लेते हैं, means, V is equal to V0 plus, यहाँ पे वैल्यू आएगा V0, इसका पहले क्या कर लेते हैं हम, ये कर लेते हैं, ठीक है, और इसका करते हैं पहले कैलकुलेशन, V is equal to V0 plus V0 T upon 546, means V0 plus, ये कितना आता है, 0.61, जो भी आता है, into T, means 0.1, V0 का वैल्यू कितना है, यानी यहाँ पे V0 is equal to 332 meter per second. Means putting this value यहाँ पे ये पूरा value कर दिया V0 का value कितना है 332 meter per second. ये value calculate करके यहाँ पे आएगा means 0.61 into T. ये आया तुम्हारा value. Seems.
There is the change in the velocity of sound also. So here this equation is equal to 0.620 gives you here the direct effect of temperature on the velocity of sound. So try to understand these expressions. Go through the books. If you have query, if you have any questions, any problems, any doubt, then please ask me. So thank you so much for watching my video. Okay, thank you.